Hi and welcome back to Ultrasign, and we are going to listen to Master of Ceremony. That is a music project from a person called, named Sascha Paeth. And he is a guitarist from a band Avantasia. And Avantasia had a tour some years ago when they had a special singer in the band. They had a guest singer, or what you call it, a touring singer with them, named Adrienne Cowan, and she's the singer for this band, Seven Spires. But Sascha Paeth fought I understand why he fought it, that Adrienne is so good singer, so he'd when he started a new project, Master of Ceremony, he want her to sing on it. So, well, and they released some stuff, our album, 2 years ago. And here is a song that is called Die Just a Little, and it's one of my new favorite songs, I think, that I have discovered of the this couple of years. Are you ready?
Yeah.
I just felt I just continue talking, you know, so okay. Well, for you maybe. Yeah. Okay, play.
Dim black night, we are
Yeah. So I can totally see why you like this. There's so much to say about this, actually. Can I?
Yeah, okay. Go on.
It's not that much, don't worry. it's a very good song. It has also some kind of Eastern folk music in the melody somehow, which mm-hmm. is this melancholy. You know, first mm-hmm. of all, it's a very strong song. It's really, really good. And then you know it's serious when the drummer has leather gloves. Then you know this is something serious. And then when the keyboard player, piano in this video,
yeah.
has this serious beard. Great. and she looks really cool. And, you know, yeah, I'm sure the guitar player does too. But this was just, it was no searching for special effects or stuff. It was just standing on its own.
I feel it's a very clean track. Not in the mood, it's a clean sounding at all, but it's very straight on the point, very classic metal sounding melody. And sometimes I miss it. You have too much of progressive stuff, just because you should have it, not because the song gets better, you know. And this is very straight to a point. Okay, it's this boom, it's this guitar sound, it's this except this little part when she's growling or screaming more, but well, it's very classic, and it could have been written 25 years ago, I think. Yeah. Well, except Adrian was 1 or 2 years ago then. But
yeah, okay. Someone could have.
Yeah.
25 years
ago. Yeah.
You're right. That's how I felt too. That's what I meant. No searching for effects with the song, the sound, the video. It's just, this is the song, and it sounds fantastic. Production is very good. But you always play it.
Sascha Paeth is a music producer, except not only a guitarist or band member, he's a producer of other bands too. So, yeah.
Yeah, you can, I mean, this is.
Do you remember we listened to Beyond the Black Human, that with the mask song?
Yeah.
Yeah, he has produced some of their stuff. So,
I think I said with them as well that it was very, very well produced.
Yeah. Yeah, you said, yeah.
You usually play very well produced tracks, but it's,
I think it's something in the this genre, this music.
It has to be done.
Yeah, if they are they are music nerds, and you know they want to. They want to sound perfect too, you know. Even if it's dirty guitars and stuff, it have to be.
Yeah, but it's not like the death metal bands from the 90s. It's not that kind of dirt. This is like more of energy and massive than dirty.
Yeah,
dangerous or whatever. That's hard to explain, but this was very good.
Yeah, and she's one of my favorite singers. She has a very, very range. Yeah, I think I show you a bit when she just growling and I really, really like her own stuff in Seven Spires, but. When she does this thing with other people, she really can show how good she is. Not, you know, it's one thing to do your own stuff, I have wrote this. I can sing it because you wrote after what you can perform.
Yes.
But when you do someone else stuff, you have to do with how them thought about it.
Yes.
So, she proves once again for me that she's fantastic and she's not old. I think 25, 26, something like that. And she's already one of the best singer I know. Okay, not the best of the, but soon she's there, you know. Give her some more training, some more years, and she's going to be one of the best, I think, metal singers out there.
I could say that now because I'm not, you know, I don't know as much as you do about the style, but I don't know what.
Well, there are so many good and people and singers like Flor Jensen and stuff that is, you know, 110 of 100 in how they can sing. They can sing everything, and I think, you know, but you have to do it a lot and you have to practice a lot, and Adrienne is going to get there because she want to, you know, evolve. She wants to learn new stuff and always be better.
And
I think I heard her say in one interview when they ask, why do you growl? And she answered, well, because I couldn't. I think when you think about your own voice and in that way, you're going to be, it's not, oh, I'm good enough, you know. She's good enough long ago, I think, because everything I heard from her is top notch. But with that way of thinking, I'm so sure she's going to be one of the really, really big. And
I'm sure because it's only about ambition and your mind. Because I mean, the day a musician or an artist or a producer or someone who creates art or is a, you know, an actor in theaters and stuff, when they say they don't need to evolve anymore, then that's goodbye. That's retirement, because it's kind of it's a driving force to, you usually press yourself to what I mean to your limit, but when you have achieved that, you want to take the next step.
And
the better you get, the more difficult it is to evolve a lot. But you have to push it to keep interest for yourself.
Yeah, and that's one of the things. She don't just sing clean. She don't just grow. She don't sing beautiful. She can have so many layers. So she have so many way to grow, you know?
Yeah.
It's not like, oh, I'm your only good. It's hard to say, but you can be very, very good at one thing, you know, and very bad at other stuff.
And you can stop with that.
Yeah, and you can be fantastic. You know, an opera singer can be fantastic, but can't sing Elvis, you know.
absolutely not. That's that just doesn't work.
Yeah, but with Adrienne, they could, but with Adrienne, I think she's gonna. She can do so many stuff already, and I think she's only gonna be better. And the future looking bright for them, for her, for her band, for the or top notch in every way. I think when we meet again about in 10 years or 15 years, Adrienne Cohen and Seven Spires going to be one of them. You know, the band that people talk about in metal. I really think that.
Or outside metal.
Yeah, but I mean, I mean, when you talk about Metallica, you're still talking about metal. So,
yeah, but that was a long time ago.
yeah, but you understand what I mean.
I know. But yeah. I mean, they have to blame themselves.
and it's a hard place to, because there are so many good bands and stuff like that. But because they try to do different stuff and different styles, and I really think they have a good future.
Yeah, and it also keeps the interest alive for the audience. That you know they always deliver, and then you get something more, something new, and you see the progress that they made, and that's the interaction between artist and an audience, I think, and this is how you keep on evolving.
Yeah. Absolutely, and I love to see that in band and in artists that keep trying new stuff and keep, because that's the best way to evolve. But this song, I think, is a song that I think I'm gonna listen to, you know, for the rest of my life in some way, and It's one of them new classic songs, you know. You have some in a different part of your life that, okay, you go back to listen to Queen or Pink Floyd for me, you know.
Yeah.
And I think Adrian Cohen has done something with this band and her other band, but just with this song, I think in 20 years, I'm going to go back to this and feel, okay, this is nostalgic. This is perfect. This is still a very perfect song. and it's not often I think so when I listen to new music. But she have something, this band have something. So that's just a perfect combo for me.
I think the song could be huge. Anywhere, I think it was just this timeless, great song.
Yeah,
and you know, to me it could be something that most people like.
Yeah, and I hope they do more stuff after they're done. Seven Spies just released a new album, one of the best. I think the best this year for me, anyway. They will start touring, I hope, after this year, I think. And after that, I hope Sascha, Paeth, and Adrian come together again to do more stuff, because I want more of this kind of music too from her.
Yeah.
So I really hope for that too.
I mean, I'm sure they will if this is the result, but then you don't know if maybe they don't agree.
But you know, you don't know how big Seven Spies is in 2 years, you know. They can be really big and don't have time for other stuff.
Yeah.
This touring is new, recording.
Or it could be the other way around.
Yeah, but I don't think so with this band. And I don't think so with his other stuff too, because he has so many good things out there too. So,
yeah.
But you can always hope, and they are still good friends. So, but they can start to tour with this stuff, because then they're going to tour in Europe. So would be nice. Okay. I shouldn't play something from them or her, and because, you know, I just want to listen to more stuff than, you know.
Yeah, continue. But I really like that, because that's passion, man.
Yeah. Yeah, and that's the thing with her voice. She sing with so much patience and feeling and expressions, and And well, that's one, that's what make a voice perfect, I think. You're not very good, not just good or perfect in sound, but when you tell something, if you can tell something with your voice.
Yeah.
And she can.
She can. And you love it. And that's why you shouldn't stop playing.
No, but we have other stuff to listen to today. But
we do.
Yeah. So, okay. But more Seven Spires and stuff later. Bye. Yeah.
Bye.